In this video, I'm going to run through some advanced cervical spine exercises. Please, however, before you attempt anything you're about to see, be sure that you do not have any pain in your neck above the level of 1 or 2 on a scale of 1 to 10. Also, before you do any of these exercises, please have a look at our next stretching video and our beginner's neck exercise video. This is not for somebody to just turn on the computer, have a look, and get going. Please be careful. We're going to begin by strengthening some of the muscles that are in between the shoulder blades that are the foundation, so to speak, of the cervical spine. And very simply, this is done. If you're doing this on the floor, take a rolled up towel and put it on your forehead so we don't crush your nose. We want to lie face down, palms up, and we want to squeeze the shoulder blades together and bring the arms up as if we were taking off in flight. And we're going to hold that for about 5 seconds and drop. Breathe out as you bring those arms up, and breathe in as you bring them down. Really feel those shoulder blades squeeze together. And we can repeat this anywhere 4, 5, 6, 7 times. And we're about to progress them by doing the same exercise, lifting those arms up, and now looking up straight ahead. Head down, shoulders down. Last one. Our next exercises are require the use of a TheraBand. The lightest TheraBand possible. Unfortunately, they're all color-coded. However, unfortunately, not all companies use the same color. Typically, yellow is the lightest that you're going to find. However, please make sure that you check the resistance label on the box. You can get these at Kmart, Modell's, Dick's, anything like that. And we're simply going to put the band around our head, hold it with the left hand, keeping the rest of the body still. We're going to gently glide the neck against the TheraBand. Hold it just for a moment or two to stabilize, and let it come back gently. Breathing out. And in. Remember to maintain good posture the entire time. And we'll run through 4, perhaps 5 each side. And now we wrap it around the front and cross them from behind. Hold our arms behind our backs like so. We can now work TheraBand in flexion. Or looking down. Not a lot of resistance is necessary. It also is not necessary to run the entire range of motion. A phenomenon called the therapeutic overlap, which simply means doing an exercise to a certain degree in the cervical spine, for example, it's 15 degrees, is just as effective as doing it 15 degrees more. For example, if you flex your neck to 45 degrees, you are getting the same benefit as if you were flexing it to 60. Now if we wrap around the back of the head, we can do our chin tuck with some light resistance. From here, we wrap the TheraBand around the back and we do some basic presses. Activating the muscles of the chest. We're not going for strength. We're not going for definition. Our goal here is stabilization. Stabilizing all the structures that are at the base of the neck, the pedestal, so to speak. And finally, the last exercise we'll use with the TheraBand is the standing row, and we're going to use the door to assist us. Simply fold it in half, take the looped end, open the door. Wrap it around the doorknob on the outside, close the door, lock the door. We step backwards with two loops in each hand, and we simply bring our arms back, and we squeeze the shoulder blades together. Good posture the whole time, neatness counts.